sunrise between the trees. It looks so beautiful, so beautiful.
And they filled Madagascar.
Now some buildings. To my right is INS Hamla, the naval headquarters training center. Hi, sir.
Hi.
How do you do?
Good.
Enjoying your drive?
Always.
This time you're not in night mode, you're in a morning mode.
Huh?
You're in a morning mode.
Morning mode, nahi, it's run mode. Sports mode.
Sports mode for your new terminology now. I have to get used to sports mode.
When I start doing right, left and middling traffic, that is sports.
Wow. Okay. So first
it's
time we are
traffic
coming.
Special.
First time we are coming in the nano over here? On this road?
Yes. Come here before, but never for the feast of Banaras.
Ah, yeah, yeah. We come by car.
We come for fishing.
Okay.
My mother.
Okay, okay.
My mother and Clyde.
Yeah, you get good fish.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, that was nasty bumps. Sorry for the jokes caused into that. Now there's a road in very bad.
Let us know the condition of the road.
You see a lot of cars on the road early in the morning at 7:30 because a lot of people going for the feast of Saint Bonaventure to a place called Erangal on the way, just before Mud Island. This is a very ancient church, which was 450 years old, with walls of at least 5 feet thickness, but didn't have a roof until very recently. They put an asbestos sheet recently, and once in a year, mostly the second Sunday of January, is the feast, and people from all over assemble here. There are masses right from 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and people go there for a picnic. They enjoy this day there, stay there till evening, have a lovely lunch, have a lot of songs, dance, fun. Every year some bands playing around. It's a very festive atmosphere. I don't know if we'll be able to capture some of it, but if possible, we will do it because we are not going to stay there for too long. After the mass, we intend to leave back and go home because of some other engagements that we have today. Well, lovely road, somewhat similar to the road we find when we go to Borai, the region. This is probably the only stretch in Mumbai, the mainland Mumbai. Such a beautiful, quiet road with trees all around. Well, the windscreen doesn't seem to be very clean. You can see some spots there. See it, and needs to be rectified. Didn't get the time to clean it in the morning, I believe.
I just went to fuel up.
I know, little late. Wanted to catch up for the mass on time, so didn't get the time. Opportunity to clean the windscreen.
And we underestimated my drive.
Yeah, that you can see the sun through the trees again.
Huh?
A little bumpy.
We underestimated road. My driving once.
What do you mean underestimated your driving?
We thought we'll take time to reach.
Yeah, I know. Although we are late, we got a little traffic on the road, although we are expected to reach faster. And actually, we are supposed to wake up earlier, but snoozed off a little longer. In fact, we'll see you who opens up. For a change.
For once.
For a change.
For once.
Otherwise, oh, gode jaise neend, gode bech ke neend sota hai na, aise sota hai normally. लेकिन आज उसने हमको उठाया.
ट्रिप मोड.
थैंक यू सीनियर.
ट्रिप मोड
फॉर डूइंग दैट.
ट्रिप मोड.
ट्रिप मोड. आई नो इट इज अ ट्रिप पिकनिक काइंड ऑफ अ मोड. देन सीवन वेक्स अप ऑन हिज ओन. नाउ स्टिल अ लॉन्ग वे टू गो अहेड. दिस ओनली इज अक्सा आई थिंक. दिस प्रॉब्लम ओनली अक्सा. स्टिल वी हैव अ लॉन्ग वे टू गो. विल एक्चुअली सी द सी फ्रंट ऑन द वे.
And before this church reach, is facing the sea, guys.
Before we reach Erangal. Erangal is a village near Mud Island. Mud Island is in the outskirts of Mumbai. We have to go via Malad. So there is another way to go reach there, that is via Versova with a ferry. That's also a beautiful drive. Very often we go by the ferry, and two-wheelers are allowed on the ferry. Unfortunately, cars are not allowed, so we have to go all around via Marway Road, Malad, and take this stretch of road towards Mud Island. This is called Mud Island, and it's very picturesque indeed. It's by the seaside. No development allowed here. That's why you don't see too many buildings. And a lot of original beauty is still intact in Mumbai. There'll be some villages ahead, especially ones like Arangal and Mud.
But people, can you believe this? This is Mumbai.
This is Mumbai.
So green.
So green. So green, wow. Yeah. It's the only stretch. Oh, another stretch like this, you will get it in RML Colony.
Yeah.
That's again a no development zone. There were no roads there. In fact, now one road is made through it. So many people cut past through it to reach Powai from Goregaon. Well, now this looks something like a rural area.
But it's in the heart of
Mumbai. It's very much in mainland Mumbai.
Well, we were very lucky to get a place for parking. And now we are on our way towards the shrine. It's a good 200 meters walk from the main road to the shrine, which is bang opposite the beach. While we are walking towards the shrine, let me tell you something about this village. It is called Arangal. The residents are mostly farmers who plant vegetables in the fields around their villages. One would wonder, how is that this church is built in a remote place like this, which does not even have a Christian population? The story goes to over 400 years ago, when the Franciscans brought this village for the upkeep of their school in Poisar. The village was bought in 1554, and the church was built exactly 45 years later in 1599. That makes it a whopping 418 years old. That is older than the Taj Mahal. Then why was it abandoned and turned out to become a ruin? Well, it is said that the Church of Our Lady of the Sea was built at a mud, which is a Christian settlement. And most of the people started going to that church, and so this church was abandoned. There are also stories that these villages were evacuated twice, once due to the outbreak of plague, and second because the English rulers were afraid of a landing of the Japanese army that was supposed to take place during the Second World War. We can hear the festive music being played in the stalls nearby, the village ambience as we approach nearer to the church. The crowd is thin at the moment, it's quite early in the day. It's not even 8 o'clock, in fact we have planned to reach the church for the 8 o'clock mass. An hour or two later, this place would be very crowded and would be very, very difficult to walk on this road. A lot of people will come to buy the ghumats and matkas, which are sold by the villagers. We'll see a lot of vegetables being sold from the nearby farm produce. We can see turnips, radish, arkol, as you can see in front of you. People dressed in their festive best, walking towards the church. Some more ambience of the Christmas just gone by. We can hear the announcements from the church already as we are approaching very close to it. This place would be teeming with people, and they would be settling in the fields around this place for the rest of the day and have a nice picnic. Prepare their own lunches with mutton bought nearby and enjoy to the music being played from the bands nearby.
आपला सर्वांचं संत बोलावे तर सरानिमित्त हार्दिक स्वागत आहे.
We can see the church just ahead and also hear the announcements being made from the loudspeakers. Devotees would buy candles, garlands to offer to Saint Bonaventure. When they visit the church, we shall take you inside the church later on. There is a very good police bandobast and a lot of volunteers helping the devotees as they come to make their offerings and say their prayers at this shrine. Right ahead you can see the entrance for the devotees who want to go for veneration directly into the church. And so many shops selling candles and garlands all around. Straight ahead is the sea. To my right is the church, very freshly painted, whitewashed as usual every year.
आपलं सर्वांचं संत बोनावेंचर सणानिमित्त हार्दिक स्वागत आहे. You are welcome to Saint Bonaventure Feast. We celebrate this feast every second Sunday of January.
Well, the boat tells you.
Hasan, dar varshi Januaryच्या दुसऱ्या रविवारी साजरा केला जात असतो आणि इथे दर गुरुवारी नवनीची प्रार्थना असते संध्याकाळी 7 वाजता. You are welcome to Saint Bonaventure Feast. Now there is a 8 o'clock Marathi Mass. For this holy mass, please take your entrance straight to the beach at the right hand side in the pendulum. Only for the offering you can go beside the church wall inside the church. For the holy mass,
the church is facing the sea. And the entrance, the shamiana for the mass is prepared outside the church. Lot of wares being sold all around. I'll take you straight towards the sea and after that bring you to the shamiana where the mass is being held. This is the road approaching the sea. Lot of people coming from the surrounding villages use this road and the beach to come to the church. Food stalls, restaurants being readied for the big rush for breakfast and lunch which would be happening there. Can already see the sea ahead of you. And there is a big mela all around with merry-go-rounds and giant wheels as you can see in your picture. This will give you a feel of the mela around for the celebration of the feast of Saint Bonaventure. I'll take you still closer to the sea so that you can see the waters. Still the crowd is sparse because as I told you it's quite early. This place will be very crowded an hour or two later. Well, there's the sea. Over 1 lakh of people visit this feast every year. Maximum people who attend mass here and the festivities that follow it are the East Indians from the various villages of Mumbai, now called Gautans. Well, you see some strange sights here too. You can see that small tempo in the water, stuck in the water, or is it forgotten by some of these vendors who are too busy setting up their stalls for the food. This is the Arabian Sea, facing the church of Saint Bonaventure of Erangel. Thank you. Now I will pan the camera and show you the church from the beach side. Noodles getting ready, lollipops fried, getting ready, omelets being fried. And there is a church. In the distance you can see white and yellow. And we'll have a little closer look at it as I zoom in on the church. That's a beautiful sight. And very soon I will take you inside this church. Now we are inside the church. You can see the decorations and the altar straight ahead. Still, the crowd hasn't come in much. As I told you, it's quite early. I pan around to show you the entrance from which we have entered and the glazed tiles, which is of course not to my liking, because no more it is giving the look of that 400 plus year old church I was talking about. Now it is covered by asbestos sheets. You can see the statue of Saint Bonaventure. I will tell you something about Saint Bonaventure. He was born Giovanni, an Italian, a medieval Franciscan scholastic theologian and philosopher. He studied in Paris, and his contemporary was Saint Thomas Aquinas. He was born in 1221, lived for 53 years, and died in 1274. He was canonized 200 years later in 1482 and declared a doctor of the church in 1588, almost a century later. Here you can see the roof I was speaking about, asbestos roof, renovated in the 1970s, and made to look like a new church, thereby losing the beautiful heritage value that it had, the 5 foot thick walls that made it. Lot of devotees come and pray. We have exited the church from the courtyard, which is to the side of the church, and we have emerged back out again towards the entrance. And you can see the sea ahead. And soon we'll be moving into the Shamiana where the mass is being held. Fried bananas, have you seen that before? Well, I believe this is available only in this part of the country. I've never seen it anywhere else. Vendors with their goods ready to hawk the shingaras and kasras. This view is just from front of the Shamiana where the mass is being held. And I will take you into the Shamiana where the priest is about to start the mass. These are the boiled groundnuts, shingaras and kasras, which are very famous, and also the boras. Any devotee who comes here buys these things and take it home like a kind of a prasad and give it to their dear ones. Volunteers manning the gate of the Shamiana, and I will take you inside.
सर्वत्र एकत्र होत
there is the altar straight ahead in front, and various blocks created on either side of the aisle for the people to stand peacefully and attend the mass. Very good arrangements made here. The volunteers very busy taking care of the devotees, seeing that they are well taken care of. Masses are held every hour, right up till 12 o'clock. A closer look at the altar.